Hello YouTube, yeah, you guessed it, it is a CNC controlled floor sweeper for the garage, and now when the floor is clean I will use it for other purposes. I think I can use it for plasma cutting as well. And here is an overview of the parts. This is the plasma cutter, or the motion parts of the plasma cutter itself, and the control part we have here. And I think all of my projects start like this. This is a really rough prototype with the cables on the floor and everywhere and so. And then I refine it more and more until I'm happy. And I know this mechanism here has some weaknesses, but let's go over it. The y-axis here, this is an HDR25 profile. I bought two of them. I used one of them in my sawmill and this one was left over, and so it came in very handy here. This is very stiff, this wagon here. But this part over here isn't really. And I'll see if I can replace that with a steel one today. So the x-axis here, it uses now one linear rail, NGN12 type on the top, and there is one on the bottom as well. So these are 30 by 30 aluminium profiles. I used to have that type of wheel mechanism that you have on 3D printers with those type of wheels there also on the x-axis, but that was clearly not good enough. And all those 3D printed parts here, well, they are quite flexible and not really up to the task here, so this is going to be redesigned here, but that is a little bit later on there. And all axes, they are driven like this, a belt and a small pulley, the y-axis and also the x-axis and even that one. And I think that is fine. It isn't really big forces here, it is more like the mass forces of the thing and acceleration and all that. And z-axis or c-axis, whatever you like to call it, it has some features. There is that type of floating switch, so there is a separate rail here, that is that type of drawer slide. So there is a floating switch, so when this is run into the bottom or into the material I want to cut, it gives away there, and this so-called floating switch is activated. That's how you know when you are reached the material. There is a breakaway switch as well. And it goes up if it hits something and goes out of position, it activates there. And this is 10 small magnets, or 20 small magnets actually. It works fine. A brush holder, or I mean a torch holder, there, so I have got this type of torch, I put it in there. And I think that's that. One really have to have some type of cabling arrangement here. I have used those cable channels and they work fine. The CNC software I use, that is Linux CNC with a Qt Plasma interface. And it has quite some features, and I cannot go into all of them, but you can do that on the fly, so to say. So here are some parameters, and it looks like a lot here, but this is for the start. Here you say you can start 3 times, and you wait 1 second between there, and there is a scale for the voltage, and I will come to that. So in principle, this is set up like a 3-axis milling machine. There is a Mesa card, yeah, because I run Linux CNC. 5 volt power supply, 24 volt power supply for the stepper motors and for the field logic. Stepper motor drivers, X, Y, Z, or the other way, doesn't matter really. And some inputs and outputs, and there is one interesting thing, and it's that one. So when a plasma cut, there is a voltage between the torch and the ground. Dependent on how far away you are from the material, this is something like 100, 120 volts, 140 volts. Dependent on how high amperage you have, or and how far away from the material, and it is the far away from the material that we can control. So this one measured that. This is that 300 volt variant, and obviously you should not buy that one, but for this one it actually works very nicely, because this one has the 300 volts output directly. So it's a non-scaled output from this plasma cutter. Many other plasma cutters, they have resistors in series, and you have to do a little bit math, and you should select another one, that 5 or 10 version. There is now a 2 version as well. So what this one does is take the 300 volt input there, convert that into a frequency, say 30 kilohertz for 300 volts and maybe 10 kilohertz for 0 volt, and that electronics over there can easily count that frequency and thereby determine the voltage cell, and then you can control the process from that. So you control the height of the torch depending on the voltage cell. That is the torch height control. That is what everyone says that they want to have, and this one is it. Apart from the frequency output, there are two pairs of cable, and that is one input and one output from the plasma cutter. The input is to start the torch, start cutting, and the output, that is the arc OK. So the plasma cutter says that yes, now it is working fine. Please go ahead and cut, kind of. And when you lose arc OK, everything stops and you have to try to do something. So that's what it is. And if you watch my previous video, you saw that I have a bit of a problem to get the arc going for the thick material. And I think I have troubleshooted it, and it is actually, I used too high air pressure there. So a little bit counterintuitive there, because I thought that, yeah, I had to crank up the amps and also the air pressure. But it turns out that the air pressure, you cannot go too high, because it is the arc stabilization there that, yeah, long story short, lower the air pressure. And I am at least able to get going for some time. I think I'll stop there by myself now. So this is a 25 millimeter. Can we zoom there? I don't think, yeah. So I came, yeah. So I at least I started it then. But it didn't come through there. I think I have to cut really, really slow there. Yeah, so this, it says 55 amps, but if I compare it with the hyperturn settings, and it is nowhere near that, it is maybe 30 amps. Anyways, that's that. So what shall we do now? I guess I have to show you a cut then, or? Yeah, let's do that. Not so quick there. I am going to stiffen up that joint there. Not really that I need it. It isn't very solid and so, but actually it isn't needed. It can be like this, but yeah, I have prepared stuff, so I will take it apart and fix it. We missed the best part when I unscrewed the joint there, but the belt has to go now. Then the belt is gone. And can I put it upside down without breaking stuff? Yeah, here you can see the x-axis motor and the supporting bearing there. Here we should remove that. And so a little bit of a complication. And oh, this wasn't really tight. Yeah. Yeah. So this plastic part here, this 3D printed plastic, I have had several iterations. I started with a blue roll, and I think there are maybe just a few blue left. Then I went over to a gray roll of plastic. There are quite a few gray parts still in use, and now there is a black spool of PLA. It's all done in PLA, this. So I think I have used so far 2 kilos of PLA, and it takes of course an immensely long time to print all that. I don't know what it can be, many weeks it feels like. There is something going on there, it should have gone out. Okay, so it was that switch there. I saw that switch there. Obviously that was glued in place. So now I will replace this with a steel version of this one. But I just painted it, so yeah, what do you want to do? Do you want to wait for the paint to dry, or? Well, you can do that. I will cut here. Ta-da! Well, it isn't fully cured there, so with a little bit of luck, in this will act as a glue layer as well then. Anyways, let's speed this up a bit. Strong enough, I would say. Yeah, I skipped over the boring details there, but it is now there. And the belt is on again. Tightened up. I just need the limit switch here for the x-axis. And yeah, I cannot have a screw there. The belt is running in there, in the groove there. So I think I just glue it back there. I think if I do it there on the bottom, it should be all right. I get the same problem when I take it off next time. And there we go. Now it is done. And here it is. I added an extra rail here. And as I said, it isn't really important this way, because the torch, it touches down on the material, and after that it regulates the height with the torch height control. So it can live without a perfectly good z-axis. Yeah. There's a little bit of sloppy in that wagon there. So anyways, let's try now. I have no idea about the cutting parameters really. So did it work or not? It worked! Beautiful! Not beautiful on the backside, there are a lot of dross, but it works! That's awesome! Let's see if I can do something fun now. It went fine, it went on slow though, but yeah, this is something I can optimize, I guess. So right now, I don't know exactly what to do with it. It seems to work alright, but I cannot have it like this. So either there will be a follow-up when I throw this away, or I will do something else with it. Do something more sturdy or more permanent. But I don't have enough room so I can have a table standing in a place where I only cut once every month. So it will have to be something foldable. Anyway, that is something for a coming episode, if any. So thank you for watching and have a good time.